Number 1. What is the total mass in AMU of carbon in each of the following molecules? And then we have letter D. So in this case, we have a huge compound, it seems, right? This is really pentane. I know that from organic chemistry. Ooh, I love organic chemistry. That's a little weird. But anyway, this is just CH3CH2CH2CH2CH3. We have to find out the total mass of carbon in this molecule. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to write it a little bit bigger. CH3CH2CH2CH2CH3. Okay, can I maybe center this? Perfect. I love everything nice and centered. All right. So, in order to figure out the total mass of carbon, the first thing we got to figure out is what is the element carbon? Well, I kind of gave you a little hint down here, right? But carbon is always capital C. So, here's a carbon. Here's a carbon. Here's a carbon. Here's a carbon. And here's a carbon. Now, once you have multiple of the same element all over the place, what I like to do is I like to combine this into just grouping all the carbons together and grouping all the hydrogens together if you wanted to. So, how many total carbons are here? Well, if we take a look, right, after every carbon, I don't see any number, right? Usually there's a number or a subscript after, an element telling you how many you have. You see how for the hydrogens, there's like a 3 here, there's a 2. They're all after the hydrogen. But there's nothing for the carbon. So what does that tell me? There's a secret 1 after every carbon. So you only have 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here. So how many total carbons do you have? Yeah, you have 5 of them. So this is technically C5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If we wanted to find out what the hydrogens were, right, you would add up all of the subscripts for the hydrogen. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So C5H12. Now this looks a little bit more reasonable. So in order to find the total mass, I write down the element that I want. So in this case, they want carbon. And we just said that carbon, there's a total of 5 of them. Now, you're always going to multiply the total number that you have in your compound or molecule by the mass of that element on the periodic table. So get your periodic tables out. There are 2 numbers on the periodic table that's usually, they should give you at least 2 numbers. They're going to give you a 6 and then a higher number. Now, on my periodic table, it's 12.01. On your periodic table, it might be a little different. Just know that these higher numbers could vary depending on the periodic table you use. But which one is the mass value, right? We're looking for the mass. Always the higher number is the mass, okay? So whichever one is the higher one, sometimes they actually put the mass down here. Look for the higher number. So this is the atomic mass. And in this case, we're dealing with AMU. That's the smallest unit of the mass. AMU, atomic mass unit. So we're just going to take that number and multiply it by how many carbons we have. In this case, we have 5 of them. So 5 times 12.05 is, I think, 60. 60.05, yeah. 60.05 AMU, and that's it. Nice. Guys, what'd you think? Let me know in the comments if this helped you out. Click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll be helping you out in more videos, okay? Let's keep going. See you in the next lesson. Bye-bye.